Some engineers built the acoustic equivalent of Lego blocks. You gotta hear this. The engineers come from MIT, Columbia University, and Disney Research. They designed interconnecting 3D printed blocks that can dramatically change sounds. The small cubes have connectors on each of the six faces. Those connectors can be open to other cubes or closed off, depending upon what you want to do. You connect a bunch of these blocks together and fit them inside an arbitrarily shaped 3D printed instrument. With a particular configuration of blocks, you can dampen sounds you don't like. Or with a different combination, you can emphasize sounds in a range of frequencies. Or you can even build your own hippo bugle and play the Imperial March from Star Wars on it. I know, because they did that thing. It was awesome. In late July, the team will present their findings at SIGGRAPH 2016, a conference for digital graphics and interactive design. Their paper has the zingy title of Acoustic Voxels, Computational Optimization of Modular Acoustic Filters. The boxes are the modular acoustic filters, aka voxels. So how does it work? Well, sound is vibration that moves through matter. By making changes to the medium through which the sound travels, you can change the nature of that sound. Take a guitar string, for example. Pressing down on a string between frets changes the length of the string, which changes the string's number of vibrations per second, also known as its frequency. We perceive sounds with a higher frequency as having a higher pitch. The interconnection of voxels changes sound in a similar way as it passes through the system. Some filters can muffle certain frequencies, while some boost others. There are no moving parts and no need for electricity. It's a purely physical phenomenon. With this technology, you could also create a type of acoustic tagging for products, kind of like a sound-based QR code. The engineers demonstrated this with 3D printed octopuses. Each octopus had a slightly different configuration of voxels inside it. An app on a smartphone generated a specific noise. Holding the phone speaker against one of the octopuses, the noise traveled through the boxes inside and came out with a different tone. The phone's mic picked up the new sound and the app identified the octopus. The app could identify different cephalopods by their unique sounds. Ultimately, I think this simple technology's most important use will be to allow for an entire hippo orchestra to play the music of John Williams. I dream of that day. I dream of it a lot. That's all for today. Don't forget to subscribe to the How Stuff Works Now podcast. And be sure to come back to now.howstuffworks.com every day to keep up to date with all that's happening right now.